Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1375, Better Concatenate. Hey, welcome back to the Learn Excel Podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. I had a big problem last month. I was working on this great DVD. You know, Mike Girvin put out the Slaying Excel Dragons book, and he put together a DVD of 53 videos that go along with the book, almost 16 hours of video content, and I was building that in InDesign, and in this box here, I needed to list all of the topics in that video separated by these bullet characters, 53 of these. Now what Mike had, he had a list in, look at this, he's using Word, a list in Word of all of those topics. I needed to take those topics from Word and produce it in InDesign. So of course, my natural inclination is Excel, right? I mean, we can solve everything with Excel. So the data comes over here from Word to Excel. I had to do a little bit of data text to columns, fixed width to get rid of the numbers. All right, great, everything's good there, right? You know, but then my problem here is Excel has the concatenation character, the ampersand, and they have the concatenate function, but it's just ugly. So equal D15 ampersand. You know, that's going to show up with the two things jammed together. If I want to put that bullet character in between, that formula is going to get really, really long. And I'm always just really frustrated that the concatenate function doesn't just accept a range. I mean, why do I have to go through and specify cell by cell by cell by cell by cell? It just makes no sense to me. And this is something that's just been bugging me for a long time. And so finally, for this one, because I had 53 of them to do, I said, that's it. I've had enough. Let's switch over to VBA and just solve this. And it was not that difficult at all. I created, so in VBA, Alt F11 to get to VBA, insert module, and then I type function join. And I asked for two things. First variable is called range to join. That's a range. And then something to put between each, so that way I could put a space between them, or in this case I needed a space bullet space. All right, and you start out here, anytime you have a function, that function name has to be a variable that's used in the function. So I start out with join equal to nothing, and I say for each cell in the range, join is equal to join and the cell value and whatever text I passed as between each, either a space or a bullet, or in this case a space bullet space. And then next cell, so it just goes through, gets all of those cells. You know, but then the problem is I have a bullet at the very end. So if they passed us anything, if the length of the join at the end is greater than zero, if there was something there, then take the left, basically the length of join minus whatever between each was. So in my case, space, bullet, space, and we're done. All right, now, next problem I had was the bullet. Let's see, right here. So I copied a little bit from Word where I had the bullet, and I need to figure out what the heck character that is. So I was able to isolate that using a function here called mid, and I just kind of eyeballed it, mid of that cell, comma 8, comma 1. Sure enough, that got me the bullet. And then to figure out what that code is, that code, I use the equal code of N3, and that tells me that the bullet is character 149. All right, beautiful, right? Now, let's go back down here to our final result. So I use my new user-defined function equal join of this whole range here, comma, then what do I want to put in between each one? In quotes a space, and then ampersand char, that's the character function 149, another ampersand and another space, and check that out. Takes that vertical list of individual cells and produces a really, really nice, very, very long one bit of text that has all the items separated by bullets. Now, of course, from here, copy, go back to InDesign, and paste. Kind of crazy, going from Word to InDesign and having to stop in Excel, but that was the best way I could figure of solving this problem very, very quickly. And hey, by the way, Mike's DVD is out now, so if you are more of a, I'd rather watch someone show me how to do it than read, this is a great, great product. 53 different videos here, ranging anywhere from a few minutes up to half an hour for some of the really complex ones. So pivot tables, VLOOKUPs, if statements, the entire gamut of everything you would need in Excel. So just a great video. Check it out at MrExcel.com. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.